What's up? It's the girl with the 411, Nella D, here with special guest, MTV's WildNOut, DJ D-Wrek. Can I say cut the beat?
You can say that. You can say that. I hear it all the time.
Hey, nah, for real. I always, every time I think of your name, I got to say cut the beat.
Yeah, it's crazy how that's the thing now. I mean, my mom says it, you know. If you know, when I go home to visit, you know, DJ, cut the lights off, take out the garbage, you know, it's something.
Say it's always command. Something. Nah, that's lit. So how excited are you that WildNOut is back for its 16th season, premiering on Tuesday, August 10th, MTV? How excited are you?
I'm extremely excited because, you know, this one was one of those ones where we didn't quite know what was going to happen. You know, there was some hiccups, you know, there were, you know, some world hiccups and then some, you know, other hiccups, some network hiccups that kind of could have hindered the return, you know, the season 16. So, you know, it's just glad, we're just really glad to be back and really excited. And it's going to be, this season's going to be crazy because we had to do some modifications and, you know, kind of go out into outer space and bring you that, like, galactical comedy, you know what I'm saying, that apocalyptic comedy. So it's going to be dope. I think you guys will like it.
Yeah, like WildNOut is probably everybody's like favorite show. You know what I mean? It's that show you at home. It's, you know, you are in people's homes every single night. People watching it, even old seasons. I go on YouTube and watch the clips over and over, and just funny stuff. It gives people a good time. So I know everybody excited that the new season is coming up. I kind of want to talk about, how did you even get into being a co-host with WildNOut? Because you're like the longest standing cast member. WildNOut with Nick Cannon. So right. How did you even meet Nick Cannon and, you know, end up getting his position to being a DJ and that co-host of WildNOut?
Right. Well, I mean, I used to, when I was in high school, one of my best friends lived around the corner. He was a DJ and I was like a dancer. I used to rap and stuff like that. And he used to help me. I used to go up to his house and we'd play all the like hot records, you know, the white labels and stuff. He would go to New York and the East Coast every summer and bring back stacks of records. And they were like all the new, you know, Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince, Just Ice records, just stuff that you just wouldn't get. Oh, hold on, let me get out of here. Sorry about that.
We good.
He would get all these records that you just wouldn't get on the West Coast. And so we would just copy what they were doing on the records. We would just copy this great. He showed me how to use a mixer and, you know, we bought the little pyramid mixer and we had the realistic mixers and things like that. We could really only, he had two turntables. I could only afford one turtable. So I had one turntable. That's how I was practicing my scratching, but I was just playing records. And then, you know, eventually I moved to LA and you're doing the Hollywood Shuffle and, you know, dancing to music videos and doing commercials and little day player roles here and there, and also working as a cashier at Costco. So,
wow.
Yeah. And at one point I became a production assistant on All That. And yeah. And from there I was a production assistant on Kenan and Kel. And then from there I was I worked on Good Burger with Kenan and Kel. And
that's one of my favorite movies. Like I watch it all the time. Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah. So, you know, I watched that, you know, we did that movie and Kenan and Kel and I were, you know, really, really good friends. And so Kel introduced me to Nick one day. Nick was over at the management office and he was this little, you know, 16-year-old kid. And, you know, he just wanted to hang out and he was talented. He was charismatic and, you know, just real cool. So we just became friends. He became like my little brother back at that point. And this was like 97. So, you know, yeah. So ever since then, you know, we've been rocking. And so that's how we met.
Wow. So Kel Mitchell actually introduced you and Nick Cannon. Wow. Mm-hmm. That's super dope. So when the time came for WildNOut, Nick Cannon, did he end up just, you know, kind of bringing you into the situation as well?
Well, we were already working together. You know, we had the we were doing the Gigolo was out, and we were touring. We were on the what tour was that?
Probably Scream Tours.
We were on the Scream Tour. We had done the Scream Tour. We had done the Nickelodeon tours. We were doing spot dates all over the country. So he and I were like the 2000 version of Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince at that point.
Right, dynamic duo right there.
Exactly. So, you know, so, and, but we weren't making any money. You know what I mean? So we were actually, Kel or Keenan had left to go to New York. Nick and Keenan were roommates. And then Kel had left to go to New York to do Saturday Night Live. So Nick moved into my place. He moved into my apartment, and you know, he's just my little brother roommate, you know, just messy, leaving trash all over the house and just being a nuisance. And so I'm making fun of him one day, and you know, we just making fun of each other. I'm telling him how, you know, why do you got to be so sloppy, you know, just wash your dishes. He's like, stop yelling at me, you wash the dishes, you know, like, why are you yelling at me, you could be washing the dishes, you know. I'm like, where's your logic? Just wash your dishes, you know. So while we were doing all that, you know, you got Rap City, The Basement. I don't know if it was Rap City. There were videos playing, and you know, comedians and all kinds of stuff on BET, you know, like Comic View and things like that. And Nick was like, "Yo, this could be a TV show," you know, because me and him are talking crazy to each other. Then you got the comedy on the TV, and then the music videos and stuff like that. I'm like, "What are you talking about?" He's like, this could be a TV show. Like, you know, I'm going to be the host. I could be the host and you'll be the DJ and the co-host. And I'm like, so what do you mean? I'm going to be telling jokes from behind the turntables? I don't see what you're talking about. He's right. Like, no, this is a TV show. And I said, he said, we could just go and invite all of our favorite rappers and favorite comedians and, you know, just we'll figure it out. And I said, so are we just going to get everybody we know and just wild out? To be wilding out? He said, exactly. And that happened in 2004. And then we got the show on, MTV picked it up in 2005. So we've been on the air since then.
Wow. So this all started out from y'all just being at home, arguing back and forth, things on the TV. And he manifested this whole idea. You said the name Wilding Out, and it all just, now look at it. All these years later, yeah. it's a big brand.
Yeah, because wilding out, you know, that's a verb, you know what I mean? You know, like, you know, you'll say, oh, I ain't going to that party tonight because I heard they going to be wilding, you know, yeah, or I was at that party last night and they was wilding out. So it was just regular vernacular that, you know, it wasn't even meant to be something, you know, profound.
Right.
You know what I mean? It just was what it was. So, you know, here we are 16 years later, 16 seasons later. And, you know, I can only thank God for it. And Nick, you know, for having that insight. I mean, you know what I mean? For having the insight and vision, because I definitely didn't see it. He definitely brought me through the fog. And then when I saw it, I was like, wow. You know?
Like, mm-hmm. I mean, it's such a success. And I know, so how did you feel when things that came out with, you know, Nick Cannon getting fired from CBS and things like that? I know you was kind of like, hold on, because this is like...
You mean from Viacom?
From Viacom, yes. I'm sorry, from right. Viacom.
Oh, yeah, I guess that is Viacom. Is that Viacom CBS? I don't know.
Yeah, that's all the same. So what happened when you found out that he was fired at the time, when they was like, you know what, we're going to let him go? How did that impact you? Because I know it kind of had to be like, wait, what?
That's exactly what it was. I was actually watching Wildin' Out. It was on TV. I don't really usually tune in too often, but I was watching because I was just watching it. And all of a sudden, I don't know, a few minutes into the show, it got preempted with like the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air or something like that. I was like, what's going on? And then I'm getting texts and I'm looking online on Instagram, and I'm getting the news through social media. So I'm making a couple calls. I'm like, yo, what's going on? And then, you know, I hear what's happening, and, it wasn't as final, or it didn't really hit me until, you know, maybe 2 weeks later when the show just didn't come on at all. It wasn't on any of the Viacom, networks.
Yeah.
You know, and so I was like, wow, this show really isn't coming back. And then, you know, Nick and I talked, but then, you know, after I spoke to Nick and, you know, the show is such a staple in our community, not just, you know, the Black community, but just in pop culture, that I always knew that it would get worked out, you know, because nobody can be that. I mean, you know, you might want to teach somebody a lesson or make, you know, you want everybody to see eye to eye. You want everybody to be on the same page. So, you know, you take time out and you do that, and now we're back.
Yeah, nah, and I was so excited when I heard that WildNOut was coming back, and you know, everything got everything was cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, thank God. And just because, you know, WildNOut, even just for us as viewers, yeah, we enjoy it, but I mean, like, we have fun watching y'all, but this is y'all livelihood, this is y'all job. So
yeah, I mean, you know, I had more faith in, I had more doubts that WildNOut wouldn't come back because of COVID than it getting worked out with the, you know, the network and things like that. You know, because that, you know, COVID just stopped the world. I don't care. You could be, you know, Tom Cruise, and if they shut it down, they shut it down. It's a wrap, you know.
Nah, for sure. So, did y'all do any filming during COVID at all? No.
Well, we did one little viral thing. We did like, maybe one or two little viral things where we all got together, or a lot of us got together on a Zoom type of WildNOut thing, and you know, put it out there. But no, you know,
yeah.
Yeah,
we can't have that happen again. That was COVID was a whew.
We can't have that happen.
Like,
I need to pay for these guitars on the wall.
Okay, but no, I'm so glad, like I said though, that when I found out, like, everything got worked out and it came back, I was like, that's such a, you know, a blessing, not just because I like it, but I mean, like I said, it's people jobs on the line, especially like right after COVID. Like, okay, we thinking we can come back, and then this happened. Like, hold on,
right?
That's a little too much. So, too, I know before COVID, WildNOut had the big tours going on where they was actually taking WildNOut on, you know, to different cities and actually going to just all these different markets and doing, you know, the stand-up comedy on stage in front of so many different audiences. I want to talk to you about how that experience was to take WildNOut on the road.
So, I've been on a lot of tours. I've toured since for a very long time, since the 90s. And just to tour with these guys, you know, like, I'm the elder statesman of, you know, so I'm the guy like that likes to just go to the city, do the show, hop on the bus, go to the next city. You know, the other guys, they like to go and do their thing in the city and do whatever. But, you know, just running around with these cats, especially DC Young Fly, I don't think he had ever been on a tour bus. He didn't know that he wasn't supposed to, you know, drop a deuce on the tour bus. And literally the bus driver told us, you know, every time you go on a tour, the bus driver tells you the kind of the bus rules.
Right.
And we were all sitting on the bus, and, you know, DC is there. We're all there. And he says, you know, no deuces, you know, on the bus. If you got to go, just let me know. We'll go to a truck stop. And I would say within 3 hours, DC is in the bathroom, and the bus is smelling like an outhouse. And we're like, what is going on? DC opened the door. He's sitting on the toilet. And he opens the door. We're like, man, you ain't supposed to be, you know, doing that in the bathroom. He says, doing what? It's the bathroom, ain't it? Like, I don't know where his logic was.
It was crazy. That's just one story. So I'm pretty sure if that's how he kicked off the tour, the rest of it definitely was fried, for sure.
Oh, yeah. You know, and conceited is always the last one to the bus, you know, fully dressed. I mean, not that we don't be dressed on the bus, but I'm saying, like, you know, usually you lounge in your, you know, sweats and shorts and stuff like that on the bus.
Right.
Conceited, he commandeered the whole back lounge of the bus, and that became his room. And you know, he's a sneakerhead, so his sneakers are and his clothes are, you know, just placed strategically all in the back lounge.
Wow. That's,
he just took that over. And you know, really, Conceited can fit in half of a bunk. That's how little he is, you know. But yeah, it was great, you know. It's just so much fun. And then, you know, it's a different experience. You know, when we're taping the TV show, we get a new audience for every episode. But, you know, that might be 300 people, 250 people, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But you do these arenas and, you know, we're doing, you know, the Staples Center, Oracle. We're doing, you know, all the major arenas around the country. So we're, you know, you got between 12 and 16,000 people every night.
Yeah.
And they know the show and they are willing and ready to participate. You know, it's that kind of show. We try to keep it, you know, I mean, you know, you're going to get flamed. Everybody, nobody's safe. And it's all love. You know what I mean? And then we have some of the best artists that come on stage. Rick Ross, it felt like Rick Ross, he did so many shows, it was like he was on tour with us. Rick Ross and Yo Gotti did almost, I would say, at least 80% of the tour with us, you know. And then we would have different people. And what we like to do is show love to local artists and things like that. So, you know, say Rick Ross is headlining, but we're in a small city somewhere, not a small city, but we're in a small market somewhere with a major arena. We bring that hot local artist on stage and they get to do that thing in front of 16,000 people.
Lit.
You know, and it's great for our comedians. And it's just a lot of, have you been to one?
I didn't get to go to one of the concerts. I think they were like in Columbus. They weren't in Cincinnati. So I didn't end up going up there. I wanted to go to
one. We did do Columbus.
Yeah, I wanted to go so bad, though, but my schedule, work and stuff, it didn't line up. But I'm like, oh, my goodness, I really wanted to see WildNOut. I know y'all actually record, and do y'all still record in Atlanta?
We did, how many seasons in Atlanta? Maybe we did, like, 3 or 4 in Atlanta. So we're between L.A., New York, and Atlanta all the time. That's where we are. This last season, we were here in L.A., right now we're not in Atlanta, but we got to make sure we get you out there when we come out there to Cincinnati. Hopefully the tour picks back up because, yeah. I mean, we were only 6 shows in and COVID said, hey, man, we got to send y'all back to the house.
Right. So hopefully they pick it back up. When y'all do, if y'all come anywhere near Ohio, just know Nella D, I'm checking in, like, period.
Just holla at me.
I'm hitting you up. So I know you talked about how, like, nobody is safe with WildNOut. I remember seeing a couple of people, like, Fat Joe wasn't on it. Every time I seen Fat Joe come on there and it's the freestyle, Fat Joe let it be known, like, don't play with me.
Yeah. Fat Joe was actually, he sent out a threat that felt real. He just said, yo, I can't remember. He said something about smacking fire out of whoever, you know. But, you know, Fat Joe, he got a sense of humor. He's a good dude, you know. I've been around him a few times, and he knows how to – he understands his character. He's a real dude, but he understands his character, and he knows how to, you know, integrate comedy with all of that too. So – you know, it's funny in the seriousness when, you know, people take the seriousness serious.
Yeah.
On a show like WildNOut, it ain't that serious. Yeah. You know?
Have you ever had any guests that got serious and you were kind of like, why are they really mad? Like afterwards, because I know Azealia Banks, she was like irritated by some things that happened with WildNOut. And I know a lot of people was like, what? Even the castmates were speaking up on social media like, no.
I mean, Azealia Banks was dealing with some things that that she was probably, she was, you know, dealing with before she even got a record deal. You know what I mean? So, because DC calls his own mama ugly. Like, you know, I mean, he don't mean it like, you know, that's just, everybody is an ugly ass something, you know? And so it's not, she just took it personally, and that ruined her experience, because she could have had a great time. And if we had to stop down, and I was like, are you serious? Like, does she understand what this show is?
Right.
This is that, you know? So, you know, you can't handle the heat. You know the old saying.
Get out the kitchen.
So, but that's what it was. You know, DC was just being DC, and maybe she didn't know that.
Yeah, nah, for sure. I think that's what it was.
But that's her team's fault. Her team should have prepped her.
But I mean, if you watch the show, everybody's seen WildNOut. You know what's gonna happen. You know what's going on. So, you know, hey,
yeah,
it is. It is what it is. But what can we expect for this upcoming season? You got to give me, is there any special guests that you really enjoyed that this season that we're going to see, or any memorable moments that's like, I can't wait till this air. Don't give me everything, but give me a little snippet.
I really got to say, you just got to wait and see, because it's just the whole look of the show is dope. So just the way we have the guests performing and participating, it's a dope, you know, post-apocalyptic COVID type way that you have to see to actually get a grasp of what's happening, you know what I mean? But the funny is still there, the performances are still there, the games are there, so, and we got some new games that, you know, we're gonna play, so I think everybody's gonna be happy. And I think it'll be, you know, well re-received, you know?
For sure. I agree. Well, look, I cannot wait to watch it. Everybody that's watching this, make sure you tune in to WildNOut Season 16 premiere Tuesday, August 10th. WildNOut, DJ D-Wrek, thank you so much for chopping it up with me today. I really appreciate it. This was a really good interview. Thank you.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it. Appreciate it. Sure.